boiling point is something that we normally think of as a stable property of a substance. But it really depends on what the pressure is around the substance. So for example, water only boils at 100 degrees Celsius if the pressure is one atmosphere. So if you reduce the pressure, then those water molecules that are going quite quickly can easily escape from the water if there's no pressure pushing down on them. So you can get water to boil at room temperature.
This is really boiling water.
The funny thing about boiling water at room temperature is that it actually decreases the temperature of the water. That's because all of the fastest water molecules escape, leaving only the slow ones behind.
We're refrigerating the water.
Refrigerating the water by boiling it.
Yes, yes.
That is a cool concept. I know everyone's a big fan of liquid nitrogen, but I've never seen solid nitrogen. So we use the same trick, pumping out the very fastest nitrogen molecules. And eventually, that decreased the temperature enough that the nitrogen actually froze. I'm putting a thermocouple in there so we can measure the temperature of our liquid nitrogen. And it reads... Okay, so the temperature of our liquid nitrogen is about minus 196 Celsius, which is exactly what it should be. And now we're going to evacuate the chamber. We're going to suck the air out of there. You can see that the nitrogen is boiling.
Okay, regard. The temperature, it's...
The temperature is dropping, minus 199, dropping. Minus 200. We're coming up on the triple point of nitrogen.
Yeah. I don't know.
No?
No.
Maybe no?
Oui, parce qu'il y a beaucoup d'eau là. Ah oui, oh. Yeah.
Voyons. We are forming solid nitrogen.
Voilà, et là ça précipite.
Whoa.
Oh! Yeah. C'est rigolo.
The ice is actually getting sucked up by the reduced pressure up here. And there's a higher pressure underneath the ice because the vacuum pump hasn't had a chance to work there. Mm. I've never seen solid nitrogen before.
Sa densité est plus élevée que l'azote liquide. Par exemple, de l'eau, un glaçon flotte.
Oui.
Ici, le glaçon d'azote, de nitrogène solide, est sous l'eau. Ça coule, quoi.
After creating the solid nitrogen, we poured it onto a water bath, and we got the whole surface so cold that carbon dioxide actually condensed out of the atmosphere, and we formed solid carbon dioxide, dry ice, on the surface of the water.
Ouais. Wow. C'est très, 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 très frais. Alors, ce que tu vois ici, ce sont des glaçons. Ce sont des glaçons très, très petits, très, très petits, et qui tombent. Hein? Alors maintenant, regarde. Mais je ne sais pas si ça va marcher. Ça, c'est du CO2.
Wow.
Oui. Attends, attends. Regarde maintenant. Regarde, 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 regarde. C'est beau. Regarde. Regarde. Plus bas, plus bas, plus bas, plus bas, plus bas, plus bas. Voilà. Oh, regarde. T'as, c'est beau. Regarde, c'est beau.
C'est joli.
Super joli.
We have a solid piece of CO2.
C'est pas beau ça?
Oui.
Ce petit morceau de glaçon de CO2 solide va être propulsé hein, par une éjection d'une fumée des glaçons. C'est très joli à voir. And Jason. Regarde. Le propulsé. Voilà. Bon, à tout à l'heure.
But the world should feel the same
when you write the layers of graphite slide off the tip of the pencil.
These are called inertial frames of graphite.
Usually many layers are stacked.